वेलकम टू सेकेंड लेक्चर ऑन डिज़ाइन ऑफ हाइड्रोलिक एंड न्यूमेटिक सिस्टम्स। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द फर्स्ट सर्किट विच इज रेफर्ड एज रैपिड एडवांस स्लो फीड एंड रैपिड रिटर्न। द क्वेश्चन विच मे बी आस्क्ड इन द यूनिवर्सिटी एग्जामिनेशन आर लाइक दिस। ड्रॉ एंड एक्सप्लेन इन ब्रीफ ट्रैवल and feed hydraulic circuit. This question was asked in winter 2016. Second, give procedure and method of control of acceleration and deceleration, that is speed control, in a single acting cylinder. This question was asked in summer 2019. Third, draw and explain rapid advance slow feed and rapid return hydraulic circuit. So the answer to all the three questions are same. Let us have the discussion on what exactly these rapid advance, slow feed and rapid return means. In this circuitry, basically piston advances rapidly up to half stroke, that is up to this position. Then the speed of the piston reduces from this portion to this portion. So when the piston moves, reaches to the last position, then it returns back to its original position with a rapid speed. And that's why it is referred as rapid advance, slow feed and rapid return. And hence this is nothing but it is a method of control of acceleration and deceleration, that is speed control in a single acting cylinder. So here we have considered a single acting cylinder. Basically it is mentioned in the question paper that you are supposed to consider a single acting cylinder. If it is asked to consider a double acting cylinder, then you can use the double acting cylinder. Now, since a single acting cylinder is there, which is written by the spring force, hence we have to select a direction control valve, which is nothing but a three port, that is pump port, tank port, and A port, that is actuator port. B port is absent here. So basically it is a two position direction control valve, that is 3 by 2 direction control valve, 3 port, 2 position direction control valve. Now there is one more direction control valve is there, and it is 2 by 2 direction control valve. The function of this 2 by 2 direction control valve is either it is going to allow the fluid, or when this portion comes in contact with the circuitry, it is going to block the fluid. The component for this hydraulic circuit is as below. It consists of tank, hydraulic oil, suction strainer, pump, motor, check valve, pressure relief valve, direction control valve, flow control valve, 2 by 2 direction control valve, and cam, as well as a single acting cylinder. Let us see how it works. When the pump starts, then oil is sucked inside the pump and the pressure of the oil is increased. The pressurized oil is then allowed to flow towards a check valve. Then obviously one more safety device is there, that is, it is nothing but as a pressure relief valve. So it is going to actuate only when the system pressure exceeds, otherwise this will not actuate. And thus the fluid flows through the direction control valve. This is solenoid operated. Now when the fluid comes at this point, here it is metered, so obviously this flow is restricted, so obviously the flow moves from this portion to this portion, and thus the maximum flow is moving inside the cylinder. And therefore when the piston is at this position and up to this position, the speed of the piston is high, that is a rapid advance. When the cam comes in contact with this roller of the direction control valve, it is going to block the fluid. Now once the fluid is get blocked, so obviously the fluid is not now moving through this portion, but it is going to pass through this flow control valve. So this flow control valve is going to allow a restricted flow, and since there is a restricted flow, hence the piston speed is reduces, and thus from this 50% position to next 50% position, there is this slow speed of the piston, and thus we can have the feeding of the system. Now when the piston comes at the extreme position, obviously the fluid supply is stopped and the piston moves in the other direction, that is the reverse direction. So the reverse direction speed is again a fast, and in this way this rapid advance low feed and rapid return circuit works. Let us have another hydraulic circuitry. This hydraulic circuit is using accumulator. So the question asked in the summer 2017 that you are supposed to develop a hydraulic circuit using accumulator. The various component of hydraulic circuit using accumulator is as below. Number one, tank. Second, hydraulic oil. Third, suction strainer. Fourth, pump coupled with motor, check valve, pressure relief valve, accumulator, direction control valve, and actuator. Now basically this hydraulic circuit is going to indicate that the pressurized fluid is also supplied with the help of the accumulator also when the pump is not in the operating position. The working is like this. When the pump starts, then the fluid enters into the pump and directed toward the check valve. Then it enters into the direction control valve. So this direction control valve is a 4x3 direction control valve in which all positions are closed in the neutral position. This is solenoid operated. Similarly, the fluid is moving into the dead end of the cylinder and the piston moves in the forward direction, whereas the oil trapped in the another portion of the cylinder is connected to drain via direction control valve. If the power supply fails in that condition, this accumulator is going to supply the fluid and this will work in the same way. So this pressurized fluid is allowed to pass through the direction control valve and the system works. So this is the function of hydraulic circuit using accumulator. Let us have another discussion. The another circuit is referred as travel dependent sequence control circuit. There are many operations in the industry where a sequencing operation is required. That is, for example, in pressing operation, first it is very essential that the workpiece is to be clamped. Now after the clamping is performed, thereafter the pressing operation should be performed. So there are two circuits, and the question which are asked in the examinations are like this. Write in detail about travel dependent pressure and pressure dependent sequence control circuit. So this question was asked in winter 2017. Similarly, draw and explain working of suitable hydraulic circuit for operating two double acting linear actuator in sequence. So this question was asked in summer winter 2016. So now we are going to discuss a travel dependent sequence control circuit. Travel dependent means depending upon the travel of the cylinder, of a clamping cylinder, this actuate, that is the 2x2 direction control valve, is actuated. The various components are as below. It consists of a tank, hydraulic oil, suction strainer, pump, motor. This is a check valve, pressure relief valve. This is a direction control valve, which is nothing but 4x3 direction control valve. This is a clamping cylinder. This is 2x2 direction control valve. Obviously, the function of the 2x2 direction control valve is either it can block the fluid or it is going to allow the fluid. Then there is a pressing cylinder. So this is the main cylinder, or this is referred as the pressing cylinder. Now how it works, that we will see. When the pump starts, the pressurized oil is sucked into the cylinder, into the pump, vent pump, and the pressure of the pump, pressure of the oil is increased. The pressurized fluid is then allowed to pass towards the check valve. This is a safety device that is referred as a pressure relief valve. Then it enters into the direction control valve, which is solenoid operated. So initially, when this fluid comes at this point, obviously it is going to divide into two parts. Either it will flow to clamping cylinder, as well as it is going to flow towards the pressing cylinder also. But in the normal condition, this pressing cylinder is blocked. So obviously there is no question that the fluid is flowing towards the pressing cylinder also. Now, when the fluid enters into the dead end of the clamping cylinder, piston moves in the forward direction. So at the extreme position, it touches the 2x2 direction control valve, which means that the clamping operation is performed, means the workpiece is totally clamped. Now when it is clamped and when it is going to actuate 2x2 direction control valve, then the fluid now starts flowing toward the pressing cylinder. Obviously this is not going to pass from this end, but this is going to pass from this end, because this check valve is going to allow the fluid only in this direction, that is from right to left. So this way the pressing operation is performed, whereas the fluid from the other side is obviously it is connected to this port. Similarly, the oil is connected to the drain also, and in this way the sequence operation can be performed, and this is the hydraulic circuit using travel dependent sequence control circuit. Now let us discuss another sequence control circuit, that is pressure dependent sequence control circuit. So it does not require any actuation and it works only on the pressure difference. So how it works, that we were going to discuss. Again, this is a sequence control circuit. It consists of tank, hydraulic oil, suction strainer, pump connected to motor. This is pressure relief valve. This is 4x3 direction control valve, in which all the ports are closed in the neutral position. Then this is a check valve, which is going to allow the fluid only from left to right, not from right to left. This is referred as sequence valve. Sequence valve as well as pressure relief valve, they are very similar to each other. Even their symbols are also same, but depending upon the use, they are referred as pressure relief valve, sequence valve, or also they are also referred as counterbalance valve, unloading valve, etc. So all the valves are having similar construction, similar symbols, and all things are similar. Now this is a pressing cylinder and this is a clamping cylinder. In this way, you can develop a sequence circuit using a pressure-dependent sequence-controlled hydraulic circuit. Now let us have a discussion on how it works. Whenever the pump starts, the oil is sucked into the pump and the pressure of the hydraulic oil is increased. The pressurized flow is then allowed to enter into the check valve. Now let us have a discussion that this pressure relief valve is set at a value of 90 bar. Now it means that when the pressure is exceed 90 bar, then this valve opens. So unless a 90 bar pressure is not exceed, this valve will not work. The pressurized fluid is then entered to the direction control valve and it is moving towards port A. So this is port A and now it is coming at this point. So obviously, even if it is coming at this point, it is not going to flow from this end, because it is going to allow the fluid only from left to right, not from right to left. So obviously, from this direction the fluid is not possible, flow is not possible. Similarly, this is a sequence valve and this set at a value of 50 bar. It means that when the 50 bar pressure exceeds, this valve open. So it clearly means that up to 50 bar the flow is directed toward this direction, that is toward the clamping cylinder. Now when the fluid is passing towards the dead end of the clamping cylinder, piston moves forward and obviously the oil which is in the other portion of the cylinder, it is going to connect to the direction to the reservoir via this direction control valve. Once the clamping operation is performed, then the pressure goes on increasing. So initially the pressure was 20 bar and after clamping operation is performed, the pressure goes on increasing from 20 bar up to 50 bar, and when the pressure exceeds above 50 bar, this valve opens and thus the flow then starts moving in this direction and thus the pressing cylinder operates. So the pressing cylinder, when the pressing cylinder operates, the piston moves in the forward direction and obviously the oil is connected to drain via this direction control valve. If the pressure exceeds above 90 bar, then this pressure relief valve opens and the system will have the safety operation. And in this way, using a pressure dependent sequence control valve, the sequencing operation can be performed. So this is all about the hydraulic systems.